Okay, in the last lab, we work with the pooling, but we learn how to work with the USART. Then now we can a little bit extend our knowledge with the USART and we add the new feature. We add the interrupt. Then now we can learn how to send and receive data with the USART together with the interrupt. For this, we no longer need to use the terminal, but okay, if you want, you can still use the terminal. But we create the loopback that we connect two pins together, then the data which we are sending, we will also receive. This allows us to check if this also works, and we can try in the same time the sending and receiving of data. Then for this, I will start new project. I will start here new project. Again, I have the F4 family in my case. I have the F401 and my device is LQFP64 pin package and it's STM32F401RET 512 kilobyte of flash. Okay, my device is here, nothing surprising. Then I can start here to pick up the UART. I can search for the free UART, but I know that the UART 2 is in my case on the Nucleo kit connected to the virtual COM port. Then I don't want to use this one. Then I will try UART 1. And I can check in the user manual from the Nucleo if the UART pin on the PA9 and PA10 are free. Then I will open my user manual. Okay, I think in the user manual is also very nice table. Or maybe not. Oh, maybe not. Then we need to check on our own. Okay, we will search here. Here's PA10. And unfortunately, PA9 is not so close. That is really not so convenient for us. Fortunately. PA9 is completely different. Yeah, here is PA9. Then for the intake connection, I will use maybe very short cable, which I have with two connectors. It will be the best option. Okay, then I will search for my cable. Okay, I have my cable, then I can connect the PA9 and PA10 together to create my loopback. That it's the third pin from the bottom on the left, on the right handler on the left side. And PA9 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 pins from the bottom. This one, and it seems that the connection is okay. Then now I can use the PA9 and PA10. Okay, this configuration is done, no problems. In the clocks, I'm okay with the 16 megahertz, always okay. And here in the configuration, I first check the parameters. I'm okay with the baud rate 115,200. Because I have connected the transmit and receive, then this speed is valid for the transmitting and receiving. And I am also okay with all these parameters, also with the oversampling. And definitely, I want also the receive and transmit in the same time. If I look on the GPIOs, I am also happy with the GPIO configuration, also with the speed, also with the pull-up. I not see here any problem. But here I definitely, because I want to use the interrupt, I need here to enable the global interrupt. You can enable it here in the UART, or here also in the NVIC, where is also UART, and you can compare with the other preemption priorities if you need to change the UART priority or not. Okay, and this is for the configuration part. Now I can store my project. I will store it into my Atolic project. It will call UART2 and it will be for the Dev Studio. Why not? I will click on the OK and I will generate my code. Now he asking to open my project.